the United States of America, where the average home is twice the size of a British one. But more space can lead to more clutter. With 14 million hoarders, the USA has the biggest hoarding epidemic in the Western world.
You have stuff, and then your stuff has you.
And unlike the UK, if your home's a health hazard, you risk it being repossessed. So the need to clear up is critical.
I just need help.
Luckily, there's a radical solution from across the pond.
Order and cleanliness is pretty much the whole of my life.
These British compulsive cleaners have tackled some of the nation's filthiest homes and country estates.
That's a nasty-looking toilet.
And challenged their obsessions in the UK.
I actually feel happy.
Now, eight obsessive cleaners are heading stateside to save America from the mess it's made.
It's going to be dirtier and infesteder more than I've ever seen before.
The cleaners will pair up to clean and clear a different American hoarder's home each week.
I feel like I want to cry.
And to push themselves to the limit, they've agreed to stay over.
Yeah, right.
And immerse themselves in the culture.
What is it?
Can the compulsive cleaners challenge their obsessive behaviours?
What if I die?
And save an American hoarder from a life of misery.
This is the American dream, this is.
Or have they finally met their match?
What's that?
I believe it's a dog turd.
With anal hairs and everything.
This is Shukatu's door, because it's full of cat piss.
Ready for the big American clean.
The average American throws away 102 tons of rubbish in their lifetime, more than anyone else on Earth. But in the town of Everett, in Washington State, where lollipops are banned and there are more Bigfoot sightings than anywhere else in the world, one American struggles to part with anything.
Ever since I was a little girl, I've been a hoarder.
55-year-old single mum Britta Evans has been cluttering up her three-bedroom house for 12 years.
I hoard perfume, I hoard lotion, makeup, movies, napkins and plastic spoons and forks, somewhere between 8 and 12 laptops. It is horrible. The state of the house is just horrible.
And compulsive shopper Britta just keeps adding to her hoard.
I love bargain shopping. I often go to thrift stores. I got a dresser there for $2. I've just gotten bargains galore. The problem is I got too many bargains.
And it's not just her bargain buys taking over the home.
There's a bit of a cinnamon roll, Fruit Loops, fried rice, chicken nugget, that's ketchup.
Rotting and out-of-date food covers every surface, left there by Britta and her 18-year-old son.
This is where my son usually sits. He, like me, doesn't clean up after himself very well.
Though classroom assistant Britta may not look after her house, she does look after other people.
Britta puts everybody before herself. She's just loved by the children that she works with at the school. She makes packages for the homeless all through the year. I think she needs to start putting herself first a little bit more now.
Britta's house hasn't always been like this. When she first moved in, she loved to entertain.
People would drop by and they always were welcome. We'd sit in yickety-yak and something shifted.
As the clutter and grime began to take over, Britta's friends and family stopped visiting.
People don't want to be in here because it depresses them. I don't want a home like that. I want a home that blesses people instead.
But in order to create a home that's fit for entertaining, Britta has to take on the monumental task of cleaning up.
Doing it alone scares the crap out of me. I don't think I could do it myself. I really don't.
Fortunately for Britta, two of the UK's most ruthless declutterers are on hand to help.
Some people take drugs. I get a high on furniture polish and bleach.
52-year-old divorcee Dave from Surrey cleans his one-bedroom house at least three times a day on a quest for the perfect shine.
The problem with OCD is I've got to the stage now, I polish it so often that I can't actually put anything on it.
And his oven is so clean that he can't bring himself to use it.
It's absolutely like brand new in here. It would destroy me if I had to put a lump of pork in there. It would just be grease everywhere.
Joining Dave is Karen from Manchester, who was diagnosed with OCD 18 months ago.
Everything's got to be a certain way, otherwise I can't settle.
Singleton Karen shares a spotless four-bedroom house...
Come on, Claudia.
..with her cat, Claudia.
She goes out on a lead, and when she's out in the garden with me, I can see where she's walking, so I know that she's staying clean.
Karen can spend up to 8 hours just cleaning the bathroom. And the demands of keeping a house to show home standards are beginning to tell.
I recognise now that my OCD does control my life. It can actually ruin my day because I'm obsessing and thinking about the things that I need to do.
Karen and Dave have cleaned some of Britain's filthiest houses, but now want to push themselves even further out of their comfort zones. By helping a US hoarder, they're hoping to be able to rein in their OCD.
Going to America, I'm hoping to come back and just be able to drop my barriers just a little bit more.
It's all about control. In my house, I'm in control. By going to someone else's house, it's chaos.
While Karen's been stateside before, it'll be the first time in the US for Dave.
The furthest I've ever been is Alicante in Spain, in the Costa Blanca. And I don't even like flying for an hour and 50 minutes, let alone 10 hours six.
After travelling 5,000 miles and through 8 time zones, Karen and Dave have finally arrived in Everett, home to 100,000 people and the Boeing aeroplane factory, which is the biggest building in the world.
I've never been to the US before, and it's beautiful, the trees. Very American, isn't it? It's all sort of little shacks and whatever.
Yeah, my worst case scenario is a trailer park.
You reckon?
I did see one programme of an American family that ate raw meat all the time. That's all they ate.
Really?
And brought the kids up on it, yeah.
Oh, you're joking.
No, no.
Oh, my God, look at this thing in the corner. Oh, my life.
Just like I imagined in my head.
What's getting the alarm bells ringing with me is it's got so much crap outside, it's because they haven't got any more room inside. Look at the state of the car. It's green.
It's going to be hard because you can't polish a turd, can you?
Hi.
Hello there.
Welcome. Come in.
Are you okay?
Oh.
What? Come a long way to see you.
Oh, bless your hearts. Come on in.
Oh, my God.
Hello. This is the living room.
Is that poo on the floor?
Yes.
Oh, my good God.
I know.
Of course, that's a whopper, isn't it?
Does he poo in the house?
Sometimes.
Nice. Yeah, I noticed outside you got a welcome sign. And it's not very welcome at the moment, is it?
It's not.
Standing in here, it does make me feel anxious.
This is my bedroom.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you're joking.
This is where I spend most of my time.
So you sort of live in here. Does the dog sleep with you?
Yes. Sometimes. Sometimes he sleeps on my bed.
Yeah.
Sometimes the floor.
How often do you change your bed in?
Only a few times a year.
What?
I know.
Get
it's
away.
Terrible. Yeah.
It's like all your dead cells fall off you, rubbing off on the sheets, and you're walking the dog pooing, and you're transferring it onto your bedclothes. So you're basically sleeping in a pile of shit.
It never occurred to me. It grosses me out, but I guess it doesn't gross me out enough.
I'm absolutely gobsmacked. I just don't know how you relax in here.
Oh.
It's awful, isn't it?
Oh.
It's horrific, isn't it? It's absolutely horrific. That's a bad Kazi, that one.
Britta, has it ever been cleaned?
It's been cleaned many times, believe it or not. It's very stained. I've even tried straight bleach in it, and it remains stained.
Look at, look, even look round the bowl on the floor. Look at that.
Oh, his anal hairs and everything.
Get away! I'll pee in a bucket.
I'm embarrassed because when I look at it and see how filthy it really is, it's embarrassing because that's below the standard that I would set for anybody. And I failed to meet the standard myself. And we're coming to the dining room.
Wow.
I know it's horrible.
Oh my goodness.
You've got a chewed up chicken bone gone black on the table.
Oh, yuck.
Did you know it was there?
I didn't know it was there.
Oh, look, there's another one. Look. It's
gone
black.
Ooh, yuck.
That house isn't fit for human habitation. It really isn't. It's ghastly. It makes me feel dirty and itchy. If you said to me today, do you want to go home tonight, Dave, I'd go on the plane straight away.
Is that poo? Is that piece of junk?
I think it is.
What, that nugget on the floor?
I didn't know it was there.
It scares me to think how many more pieces of dog poo there are lingering.
Can I spray it?
That ain't gonna help, is it?
There's someone with my condition, so actually go in there and face the poo and you feel like you can taste it. Right now, I want to hide. I want a duvet. I don't want to hide in it.
By their natures, just by who they are naturally more clean. They're naturally conscious of seeing what needs to be done. And I'm naturally kind of blind to it, it seems like.
The obsessive cleaners will be pushed to the limit during the clean, and to challenge themselves further, they've agreed to stay over at Britta's.
Oh, my God. Oh, dear.
Oh, God.
I know it's a mess.
It's not fit for sleeping in. It really isn't.
Uh-huh.
I'm drawing the line on staying home.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I understand that staying here would be a hard thing for anybody to do. I'm more disappointed in myself for not having a clean enough house to where somebody would want to stay.
She's so nice, and I don't want to get her in tears. But it's the pits.
I just couldn't. I couldn't stay in this house, full stop.
Before the clean gets going, Britta, who's unable to take time off from her job as a teaching assistant, wants to lay down some ground rules.
I go out to work my job, and so I'll be out of the house in the mornings. I'll arrive back in the early afternoon. So I don't want you to throw anything away unless I've seen it and say that it's all right.
Okay.
I can assure you a lot of your stuff is going in the skip, all right? Because you're going to want to keep a lot of stuff that you don't really want. I know.
To show Britta they mean business, the cleaners make a start on the grimy bathroom.
Oh, Jesus Christ, let's get that skid off the back.
Keep scrubbing?
Yeah. Keep scrubbing?
Dave, come on, get right underneath there. I'll get you a toothbrush.
A toothbrush?
Yeah.
This is the American dream, this is. Worth coming all these 10 hours flying just to clean this Kazi.
I'm feeling overwhelmed at the minute because I feel like the rubbish is breeding in front of my eyes.
What's that?
I've got a bun.
There's a bun in
here. Is it bread? Oh, my God.
Is that his finger? God's sake.
Oh, my God.
After an hour of scouring and scrubbing, the surfaces of the bathroom are once again visible.
After a few hours or a day here, you start really focusing on what job you got ahead, and it's not good.
With one last swill of bleach.
All right, I'm staying in there tonight.
The cleaners decide they've had their fill of filth for one day.
I'm drained. I'm absolutely drained after today.
I think it's going to be very interesting to see where one extreme meets the other and how far we can come to the middle. If it comes down to really having to defend my position or my possessions, I think that I'm the type that would stand my ground.
On the west coast of the USA, obsessive British cleaners Dave and Karen are preparing to leave the comfort of their B&B. But for OCD-diagnosed Karen, the thought of returning to Britta's cluttered home has triggered her anxiety.
I'm having a delayed shock reaction to that house. I've never seen anything like it.
With the OCD, her house makes my head hurt so much. It's soul-destroying.
Karen and Dave will spend 5 days cleaning the home of 55-year-old hoarder Britta so that she can once again welcome family and friends. And they have some heavy-duty backup on hand.
That'll do ya. Crack on now.
Cool.
Sorted.
We need to pick the house up, put it in the skip.
Dave and Karen will tackle the four worst rooms. The living room, the dining room, the kitchen, and finally Britta's bedroom.
Let's get going.
But they'll have to start the monumental task by themselves, as Britta's unable to take time off her job as a classroom assistant.
Hello, what's this?
Gone to work. Please help yourselves to tea and coffee.
I don't think so, somehow to you.
Britta, oh my God.
Oh, the smell.
You just couldn't have a brew in here. It's just, it's hideous. Yeah, I wouldn't even know where to start, but there's no way.
This just needs throwing because it's beyond washing, this thing.
While Dave attempts to uncover the dining room table, Karen digs through the mire in the kitchen.
That's just gross, mixed in with all this rubbish and poo. I just see poo germs. And I'm not a germaphobe, but I can see the poo germs running all over the place.
At home, Karen can spend 9 hours a day ensuring her kitchen is immaculate.
It's just like every single surface is disgusting. What have you found in there?
But Britta's hasn't been deep cleaned in over 3 years, with leftover food covering every surface.
Oh, my God!
What have you found?
Come and look at the microwave. That's it. I've had enough now.
It's a...
Sarah!
I swear to God, I'll go sick if I touch it.
Oh. Was that being saved for later? You know what? I'm getting out of here.
It's tough in there. It's tough. You got the smell there. You got the filth there. Then I'm called in to look at a fairy pizza in a microwave. It ain't no good. Can someone live like this?
3 hours into day one of the clean, Britta returns home from work.
Oh, what you doing over here?
Well, we started clearing the space. We've been in the kitchen today, and it's just shocking.
Yeah, I had a bad moment this morning. Karen called me into the kitchen and said, have a look in the microwave, and there was furry pizza.
Oh, no.
Yes, and then... I was puking up in the bin.
Oh, no.
Then ended up in tears over there.
I feel really sorry to hear that you got sick. And I feel really sorry to both of you that it's so upsetting. I want the house to get better.
Oh!
To make amends for the cleaner's difficult morning...
We need to get this to the skip.
Britta rolls up her sleeves to dig through the junk in the bedroom.
Look at this book that's sitting around collecting dust.
The hoarder in you, how appropriate. How to live a happier, healthier, uncluttered life. I bet you've never read that, have you?
I've read it about 10 times.
I think that should go in the skip, because it didn't bloody work, did it?
Hey, how much time do you spend cleaning at your house?
I can spend a day in one room, my little bathroom. I think I was in there 8 hours once.
What were you doing for 8 hours?
Just then going over it. So I tend to go over everything twice.
Uh-huh. So clean it through and then wipe it off. And if I'm not happy, then I do it again.
Do you get to do things like go out with your friends and...
No, I don't go out.
You don't go out?
No, no.
Why?
I don't. To be honest, this is massive for me coming here. I don't even like going in shops. There's one shop I'll go in, and that's to get me cleaning products. I'm safe in my own little world, if that makes sense.
If you clean something and then you turn right around and clean it again, to me that's extreme. The time to clean is when something's dirty. I think she sounds lonely. It makes me feel sad.
She knows a bit more about me and the way I sort of tick. But right now, the hoard has got to go. So this is going to be the difficult part, trying to get her to let go of silly, silly things.
And as the clean continues to the dining room...
Come on. Hey, hey!
..which hasn't been cleared for 5 years...
A set of headphones covered in hairs. They're going.
Britta is certainly in no mood for letting go.
What?
Where's that come from? I didn't...
These are pretty. They match my decor. There's no pee on them or anything.
Have a look in there, my love.
Because you guys told me that you wouldn't throw anything away unless you had my approval. This is a perfectly good washcloth.
Britta.
That's not a poo stain.
Britta, the 50 cents at the shop. Come on, you've not missed it until now, hon.
Well, actually, I have, because I haven't missed this one in particular.
Yeah.
But when I go to wash my face in the morning, I'm thinking, what happened to all my washcloths?
Okay.
So it would only make sense to launder this. So I believe that it is safe for me to use this washcloth and that it makes money sense for me to use this washcloth. Okay. So I insist on it. That's
you
the end of
it.
That story, okay?
I think for now I'm pretty much done. I'm going to get somewhere.
Okay. I felt kind of cheated when I found these pretty things mixed in with garbage.
I'm trying to get rubbish away. She's now not trusting us. You know, but I just feel irritated.
Well, shoot. These are beautiful. I feel like now I have to watch everything real close. And I don't want to be that person who feels that paranoid.
It's the end of day one. And only 2 bin bags have made it to the dumpster. The next morning, needing to plan their strategy, Dave and Karen fuel themselves with an all-American breakfast classic, biscuits and gravy.
Oh, my living God.
What is it?
Biscuits and gravy in the old brown.
What? Gravy's brown. Where's the biscuit?
It's underneath the gravy.
I hope I'm not offending you,
not
but...
Not at all.
That doesn't look like a biscuit. That's not a digestive.
A digestive?
Yeah.
I don't know if you realised yesterday what we was doing with Britta yesterday. The only thing she was really chucking out was food items and food packaging, really, wasn't it?
Well, we've not got down to her personal things yet. It's she's OK with the rubbish,
yep.
But we've got to make a plan. We've got to persuade her.
We've just got to grab her, get her hands dirty. We've just got to get stuff in bin liners.
Just got to start decluttering.
Back at the house, the cleaners might be planning to chuck things out, but Britta is determined that her belongings don't go to waste.
If something's not garbage, I don't want it to go in the dumpster. I want it to help somebody. Ideally, I want to make a donation.
Here we go.
We all have the same goal of making my house look better, and a lot of that means things are leaving my house.
Good.
How about we do a compromise? I would feel much better if somebody else could use it that they did.
If you can guarantee it's going out of the house, I don't mind you donating some things, okay?
Is that fair?
I guarantee it, and I think it's a good compromise.
I understand that.
Okay.
But we're not just moving stuff from one area
yeah.
to another.
To be truthful, Britta, I want to see you keep to your word. I want to see it, physically see it being donated. So me and you are going to get that in the car and you're going to take it. I'm coming with you. Wherever you're taking it,
awesome.
I'm coming.
Team.
Deal in place, the new donate pile begins to grow.
That's brand new, but yeah, donate. That's okay, donate it. We can donate this. Booking stuff, you can donate.
I don't care if it goes in the skip or it goes to charity, as long as it's gone. You know, this lady needs space.
I will get rid of all these. We can donate all these, okay?
Hi. Just a 10-minute drive from Britta's is a true American staple. A vast thrift shop.
You go, buddy.
Where donated items are sold on by weight rather than being individually priced.
I feel really good.
Is it a nice relief just to get rid of some stuff?
It's a relief and it might help somebody.
Almost 20% of Americans visit a thrift store each year. And for the 1 in 8 people on the breadline in Washington state, these shops are a lifeline.
I'm really proud of Britta because I never ever thought she was gonna let go of anything. It's just it's a milestone today. We've made progress at last.
But the cleaner's small victory is short-lived. The temptation of a bargain is too much for compulsive shopper Britta to resist.
I know that I'm gonna be getting rid of a lot of stuff, and if I need it, you know, why not get it? Well, it's $1.59 a pound. When I shop, part of it is because I grew up with a fear of being poor. We used to have a phrase in our house, you know, if you leave the door open, our electricity bill's gonna be so high, we're gonna be in the poorhouse. We grew up with a fear of running out of things.
She's shopping.
Oh, no.
Unbelievable.
Oh, my God.
Unbelievable.
But the cleaners have spotted Britta in action.
What are you doing?
What are you doing? Shopping. We're not taking anything more into that house. No way.
Can't I just have just a few? We need winter clothes.
No. No, there's clothes everywhere, Britta. They're breeding. They're in the laundry room. They're in the spare rooms. They're in the lounge.
Listen, I promise when we're sorting through my clothes, we can get rid of anything that's 2 sizes less or more.
No,
than I
because
am now. And the clothes I buy in here will be clothes that will keep me warm.
Guess the way. Come on.
Come on. Three.
No.
Items.
No.
Three items.
No.
10 minutes.
No.
3 items. I said.
Oh, come on! I'm going. I'm going. Yes. This is defeating the object.
No. It's completely wrong. She's losing the plot. This woman.
Angry isn't the word. I want to drag her out of here, but I can't be physical.
It's winter time, and I know I need the clothes. I'm not lying. I'm not BSing. I need the clothes.
I feel very despondent and quite upset, really. She's upset me.
You're a thief.
Thank you.
We've lost the battle, but I think we're going to lose the flipping war at the moment.
It's the third day of the clean in Washington State, USA. British cleaners Karen and Dave are hoping to challenge their obsessions by cleaning up hoarder Britta's home.
My God. Britta's sleeping in this.
With the decluttering well underway, they've uncovered the full scale of the grime that lies beneath.
The smell in this house is horrid, and you just feel dirty.
There's 2 layers of stuff in that place. You've got the personal possessions, then you've got the grime, thick dust at the back of it.
I'm itchy.
I'm not picking it up because I'll puke.
I feel sorry for Britta, but really keen to find out, you know, her story, because there's something gone wrong in Britta's life for her to be like this.
While Dave battles with the nicotine-stained bedroom, where Britta smokes up to 20 cigarettes a day...
What the hell? Bag full of fag butts. What's this all about?
Karen and Britta wade through the years of filth that's built up in the kitchen.
Just spray it inside, hon.
Mm-hmm.
And then use some kitchen roll. There you go.
I guess it's been a while since I've cleaned this cupboard. Probably I've never cleaned it.
How did you manage to cook in here?
I haven't really cooked in here for a number of years.
When was the last time you cooked a meal in here?
2012.
And why? How come you've not cooked since then?
Because that's the year the bottom dropped out of my life.
What happened? If you don't mind me asking.
On Valentine's Day, the man I thought I was going to spend the rest of my life with, I found out he was cheating. I was devastated, humiliated, unlike no other pain I've ever had.
Oh, my God.
And the same year, my sister-in-law found a lump. And she found a lump in November, and she was gone by New Year's. And I was in the room with her when she died. I held her hand for an hour because I didn't want it to get cold.
Oh, my God.
This looks like garbage to most people, but it's basically, that's what unshed tears look like. Unshed tears look like garbage. It looks like dust and clutter and dirt and grime. I'm not very good at crying.
Oh, I can't imagine what you've been through. I don't want to imagine what you've been through. Oh. It's just, I knew she had a story, I knew, but I didn't know what. And it's like, since all that trauma happened to her, she's just died inside because she's been so hurt. Yeah, I just want to get her sorted. And then at least felt one person through it. I see a smile on her face.
All week I felt like I'm disappointing her and that she can't understand how a person could be so messy. And I think now she understands.
Having confided in Karen, Britt is now ready to crack on with the decluttering.
I'm throwing away this.
Well done.
Thank you.
Good girl. What's the score with this thing?
So that doesn't work.
And that's going then, yeah.
Okay. I am starting to see that things that I thought were worth keeping aren't worth keeping.
Looking forward to this?
Yes.
I bet you are. Can't bloody believe it. She's actually enjoying it. She's enjoying getting the crap out of there, you know, and the excitement in her eyes. She's a different woman.
Bravo!
How are you feeling, me love?
Bravo!
Yay!
Let's go get some more!
There you go.
Do you know what? I am really, really proud of Britta because she's embracing it and she's recognised her problem.
I'm very inspired by the cleaners and the help. I am feeling much relief getting rid of things that I would have normally hung on to.
And Britta's progress is also having a positive effect on Dave.
Somebody with OCD, it's just stressful for me. I can't even have a sock on the floor at home. And seeing all that stuff there for a few days, it's just driving me loopy. Now it's getting out of the house, I'm feeling alive. What's this?
Back in the UK, Dave cleans his entire one-bedroom house at least three times a day and prefers a minimalist look. Not so for Britta.
I just love these cups and saucers.
I know you do.
They make me happy when I look at them.
I'm not a knick-knack person. I'm very minimal at home.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I've got two pictures in the whole house. All these knick-knacks, it just causes work. My routine every day is the issue for me, you know. I don't need to spend the amount of hours I do in my place.
How many hours?
Well, I do it three times a day in my house. And I do light bulbs, everything.
So do you think it makes sense to clean three times a day?
Oh, no, it's madness. Sometimes I go in the kitchen, I just put the kettle on and I get this urge and I end up emptying the whole kitchen out into the dining room and I polish every single thing.
Oh, my goodness.
And then I put everything back polished, polish all the plugs, everything.
So what do you do in your spare time when you're not cleaning?
Not a lot, really.
He's so compulsive about having to repeat things over and over and being afraid to live in his own house, really. It's wonderful to be clean, but it's sad when being so clean keeps you from going out.
Your house is so filthy you can't use it. And my house is so clean I can't use it.
Yeah.
Same thing.
With a day and a half left of the clean and the kitchen and dining room cleared...
Chocolate bars.
Dave unearths some hidden treasures in an unexpected location.
Tuna salad in the bedroom. God almighty, salted peanuts. Unbelievable. Look at the food supplies in the bedroom. What's going on?
For God's sake.
Whilst in the living room...
I've got Bridget Jones.
Karen makes some surprising discoveries of her own.
It's just that horrible old soap. Cheap. Wet wipes, stay clear. I don't know how long they've been in there, but they've never been used. I do find it a bit weird that she has got so many mini toiletries that whether she used to go away a lot, I don't know.
But this is one hoard of Britta's that has an important purpose.
I make bags for the homeless, and they're called blessing bags, and they have toiletries and some food.
Really?
And when I see homeless people, I try to have them convenient in my car so that I can give it to them and talk to them and give them some dignity and let them know they matter because they're a person.
That's a very touching thing to do. That says I really admire you for doing things like that. In my head, I just thought she was, oh gosh, she hoards toothbrushes now. I had no idea about the fantastic cause behind it.
To get the hoard out of the house, the cleaners accompany Britta to a local homeless charity where the toiletries and food can be put to good use.
Did y'all want to help with serving lunch today?
That'd be cool.
500,000 people across the US are homeless, with 23,000 of these in Washington state.
Do you want a yogurt, honey?
I might as well.
Yeah?
Thank you.
Right, what else do you want?
Everything.
Everything?
I'm just kidding.
You want everything. You can have everything.
And in Everett, 15% of the population live below the poverty line, the second highest of any city in the state.
You're Australian, right?
No, I'm not Australian.
Yes,
I bloody ain't. Hi, my love. How are you?
Where are you guys from?
You enjoy it. Do you want a chocolate bar?
Volunteering with the homeless for the afternoon has had a profound effect on Dave.
Good to meet you, mate. What drink would you like?
One of these?
No.
After seeing this, my routines and rituals at home, it's really petty. The things I worry about at home, have I got any dust on my ceramic hob? It's a bloody joke. I've often said sometimes less you own, the less there is to worry about, but it sort of opens your eyes a little bit. All action, all go.
In Everett, USA, it's the final day of the clean. And obsessive cleaners Karen and Dave have been working to turn Britta's home back into the welcoming space it once was.
There's still things in the house that need to be cleaned. There's still lots and lots to be done.
And to bring the poo-stained carpets back from the brink, they've called in the big guns.
Just coming back to life, it's becoming a home.
Because Britta would love to entertain once again, the cleaners have invited friends and family over as a surprise, and they're arriving in just 5 hours' time.
A little bit of pressure, yeah, but there always is. There's always pressure in this house.
This is a huge day for Britta because it was embarrassing for her, for people to come round prior to this. So, yeah, it's her day. I just want her to feel so proud showing her home off.
After 35 man-hours, one full skip...
Job done.
..and countless donations to the thrift store, there's just some finishing touches before Britta's house is ready to receive guests once again.
It's looking 100% better than what it was. It's livable now. The dog even looks confused in there because there's no food on the floor, you know.
Before, Britta's living room was a chaos of clutter, with dog poo all over the floor. Now it's been transformed into a warm, inviting room where Britta can relax and welcome guests. which he hasn't been able to do in over 4 years. Today, Britta's mum and all her friends have come to surprise her.
You lost the words, aren't you?
I am, which is rare, as you know.
I know.
Britta, we've done this for you so that your house becomes a home again. Everyone can come and enjoy your company, and you've got the people that love you around you.
This feels perfect.
Amen.
I loved walking in and seeing people I really love and care for and not being embarrassed that they're in my home.
5 days ago, the bedroom was a dumping ground, littered with fag butts and obsolete laptops. Now it's become a bright, welcoming room where Britta can rest and relax.
Wow!
Much to her mum's delight.
I can't believe how different this room is.
It's beautiful.
Thanks, Mom.
Tropical and...
It once looked this way, and over the years, everything, all the prettiness got hidden. Mm-hmm. And now the prettiness is here again, and it makes me happy.
Britta's kitchen was a germs paradise, covered with leftover food and unwanted containers. Now it's been deep cleaned and is once again a safe place for Britta to prepare food for her and her guests.
Wow. What a pleasure this kitchen is going to be to work in. You can even see counter space. How about that?
First time in a long time.
Yeah, for sure.
In the dining room, the table was completely obscured by leftover pizza and chicken bones. And there was yet more dog mess on the carpet. Now, it's the heart of Britta's home, a place where she can entertain family and friends.
Oh, I love this room.
When was the last time you saw the table clear?
Totally clear like this? I can't say that I remember. So it was a long time ago. I've always enjoyed having dinners for family and friends. And to see my daughter do the same thing is a very important and enjoyable thing for me.
The minute that I walked in here and saw everything, it overwhelmed me. So I knew it was going to overwhelm Britta. And the personality of Britta is just everywhere.
It was like a storage unit gone wrong. It wasn't a home. And she deserved more than that. Now she can come home and feel happy again.
It means a lot to see my daughter happy, and what makes her happy makes me happy too.
With the transformation of Britta's home complete, Karen and Dave's time in the US has come to an end.
This is it now. Okay. Aww. But before we go, we've got this little token for you.
Oh, thank you.
So, these are photographs that were around the house, and these were happy times for you. And for you to look back and relate to the happy times.
I ache. I'm tired, but I've got a lot out of it. I've helped to change someone's life in a positive way. So if I can do that for someone, I can do it for myself.
It's been an absolute pleasure meeting you and getting to know you. This will stick with me for life, what I've been through here. It was a tough one. I'm feeling proud of myself for completing it, you know. It's job done. And I just want to go now. First time in America, and I don't think I'll be coming back.
When I look back on this week that I've been with you, I'll have those happy memories. As much as I didn't want to be here at times, you've filled a place in my heart. So it's meant a lot to me. You've opened my eyes too. Take care, hon.
Take care,
darling.
You guys. Be safe.
Okay.
Keep in touch.
Will do.
Love you both.
All right. I'll see you later.
Thank you.
See me, darling. You take care, all right?
You too.
Keep it clean.
Bye-bye.
You missed them already.
This transformation means starting life over again. Having a clearer space will give me the ability to hold my head high instead of be embarrassed and worried if somebody comes to the door. I'm very, very grateful to them for all their hard work and all their help. I'll never forget this week.